All right, so you tried those practice problems on the inclined plane. So if you didn't get those three answers right below the question, here's kind of your hint for you. So the sum of the forces in the x direction is zero, so we gotta go ahead and generate that equation from our free body diagram. You did want to rotate it in this case, even though the acceleration was zero, because then I only need to resolve the one vector instead of the two. So you can generate your equation in the x direction, find that horizontal force, generate it in the y direction to find that normal force. Now, in this case that it's let go, this force disappears. It's no longer a first law problem, it's now a second law problem. So when we sum up the forces, we gotta set it equal to ma. It'll look very similar to this, just no f. And now it's an ma. You'll notice the masses cancel. That's kind of cool. Didn't have to, but they do. And so then you should be able to find that acceleration. Now the second practice problem, this one's a little more intense because I have two objects. So we got that multiple mass thing going on. This is static equilibrium though. So to set this up, you're gonna sum up the forces in the x direction for our lower block after you draw your free body diagram and find out that the tension in between the blocks is gonna be the weight times the sine of alpha. No numbers here, kind of crazy. Part B wants us to generate an equation for our upper block. So I have T1 pulling it up, T2 pulling it down, and this component of the weight, W sine alpha. So I substitute in my T2 value, I get two W sine alphas. That's part B. Part C, we're now summing the forces up in the Y direction, and we find out the normal force. Part D says, well, what happens when you increase that angle? So if I have it flat on the ground, those tensions can be nothing. I'm not holding it anywhere. So when alpha is zero, the tensions go to zero and the normal force supports all the weight. As I increase that angle, that tension starts to support some of the weight. We see that here. The normal force supports less of the weight. And when I get up to 90 degrees, now the tensions are supporting all of the weight and the normal force is supporting none of the weight. So there's that practice problem.